to the director of the film Dušan Kasalica, with starring Frano Lasić, producer Jelena Angelovski, and Lidija Draginja Voganjac. Question for you, director. How was the shooting of this film? How much did the condition of the pandemic affect the work on the film and your directoring planning?
Well, actually, we shot the film before pandemic, how to say in English. Well, the process was interesting in terms that we work in a small crew, and we basically film with either no lighting or just when it's really necessary. And what was the most complicating thing for this film for me was to create these long shots, to play with zoom lenses that we frequently use, and to make the tone with the film, because we have like this huge two parts of the film. Basically, one is placed in a spa center, the other in the mountain, and how to make this entrance from reality.
On the producing film and organization sets or recording or people?
As Dušan mentioned, we had actually three times of pre-production and three times of production, and we should move from mountains to the sea and from one places to other, but yes, we always work in very intimate and small crews, and this time was the same. As a producer, I have a really great luck to work with Dušan, who realized that we should work in very specific production circumstances without any additional things which are not necessary. So I know him for almost 10 years, and we worked together as a producers on Dušan, on Ivan Salatić's first fiction, You Have the Night. So we established our way of work almost 5 or 6 years ago. So we did the same thing this time with this film. We always work with our friends and great collaborators, great professionals, and understanding and the idea of what contemporary cinema should present. We did again this time with these people, and collaboration with actors who understand what is their job really helped us during the filming. So everything was so smooth, and we are really happy that from the beginning till the end, we made this film very easy.
Evo, Draginja, kakva su vaša iskustva u glumačkom smislu kada je u pitanju rad u uslovima pandemije i generalno, dakle, povratak na scenu kao takav?
Pa, budući da pandemija nas nije zakačila dok smo radili, to je sve išlo normalnim tokom, a onda je ona zapravo odložila ovaj rađanje i život filma, tako da sa nestrpljenjem smo dočekali svi da se sretnemo s publikom. A pitanje je bilo kakav je bio rad. Rad je bio fantastičan. Divna ekipa i pored našeg razumevanja gde idemo i šta želimo, imali smo i jako lepog partnera u prirodi. Pardon, taj dormitor je fantastičan i moram da pomenem našeg kolegu Jarca, koji nam je bio inspiracija i odličan partner, osim glumaca, naravno.
Hvala vam, Mr. Lasić, your experience.
Excellent. Fantastic. No, it's the fact that actually we escape pandemic, and pandemic actually start a little bit later. But what was interesting, we filmed that actually for 1 year or something like that. So we start without snow, and then at once was snowing, and then we had to stop it and then continue next year when it was without snow and so on. The experience is exceptional because it was a small crew and very intimate crew, and director Kasalica knew exactly what he want from this film. So from beginning, as we did quite a lot of conversation about the text and the story, it was quite easy to do that. And I, from my point of view, I really enjoyed that.
Dušane, this is your future film debut. What are your experience of working on future film, and what were you aesthetic guided by when working on this film?
This film was developed even earlier than actually I planned to shoot the first feature film, because I've done two short films. One was placed in a hotel, the other one in a mountain. So basically this feature film is like aesthetically mix of the ideas and the images that I already had. I do all my films with cinematographer Igor Georgievich. So we understand each other quite well in terms of the aesthetic and in terms of what we want. And I like to work by knowing the location where we are going to shoot. So while I'm writing the script, I already know where it will happen, and I create shots in the screenplay most of the time. So we know when we are going to shoot long shot, what is going to be in several shots, etc. But there is always we are open for changes during the shooting, and as we are working with animals, it was quite a challenge to achieve all that. But basically, that's the aesthetically process of the film.
The divorce of the two heroes on the film is in the initiation of the action. Why was it important for you to tell at intimate drama in the film?
I start from thinking about communication and about dialogue, and actually at these times, as we talked earlier, it's when we see how people communicate, we actually see often that people just present themselves. It's just the presentation of individualism, of monologues, and people don't usually communicate or don't do dialogue. They don't listen, they don't either emotionally or just through the information. And with that, I start to think about character of Filip, that present one whole generation of middle class of Yugoslavia that once built this whole system and then silently watched its destruction without basically doing anything. And what was starting point for me is that I want him in the situation of marriage collapsing, but in the ambient of hotel spa, where everything is so smooth, enjoyable, boring, and everything seems perfect. But nothing is perfect. Inside of him, nothing is perfect. And for me, it was starting point to question this character in terms that he won't react on anything. When his marriage ends, he doesn't react. He just rather choose to escape, to be in his own ideas and monologues. And then I started thinking about other situations,
where he will meet other women. And while he's just running away from solving the problems or talking about the problems, he will run away in a fantasy world that in this film is Stribor Forest fairy tale.
Mr. Lasic, Filip turns to nature. How far do you think we have moved away in this moment in, with experience pandemic from our natural habitus and humans? And what was your guide for building Filip's character?
Well, as we know that there are a lot of people who rather run from the problems than to be involved in problems and fight with problems. So you know, it's always easier just to close your ears and close your eyes and do nothing, or just to go in your some inner world of thinking and viewing the things. And this is the fact. The fact is that this professor is actually running from the problems and going in a fantasy and experiencing fantasy rather than reality. But how to say, it's more deep actually the film than on first viewing is obvious. This is conflict. This is losing of middle society of in all the world. You know, you have upper and middle class and then lower class or whatever, and then actually this middle class is vanishing because of the politics, because of the war, because of the economics and so on and so on. And so actually when you watch deeply in that film, it's not just the relation of this guy and his wife and his marriage. It's actually a problem of the world, and it's actually a problem of the society that, you know, it's very, as I told you, it's very easy to close your ears and eyes and don't see anything and just go forward. And as we know, in whole world, the middle class is going away. So what to do? Just to close your ears and your eyes and do nothing, or confront the problems and fight with them?
Vaše iskustvo u tom smislu kada je u pitanju vaša uloga i uopšte pristup njoj i izgradnja samog lika?
Pa, pošto sam ja u tom delu koji je fantazija ili nešto što je inspirisano bajkom, pritom je to bajka koja je jedna od omiljenih moje generacije, mislim, u smislu odrastanja. Lepo igrati arhetip, a ta majka to jeste. I ovaj veliki kontrast između nje i sina. S ove strane imamo neki egocentrični princip, a s druge strane neko ko daje bezuslovnu ljubav. I to je zapravo veoma inspirativno.
Hvala vam. U producentskom smislu film je nastao na Cinelinku, odnosno uz pomoć platforme Cinelink. Koliko su generalno regionalna iskustva važna za film na prostoru bivše Jugoslavije i koliko to olakšava i komunikaciju i samo kreiranje prilike da jedan film bude snimljen? Možete na engleskom da prvo?
Yes, we developed this film at Cinelink co-production market in 2018. Before that, Dušan was awarded with his short film twice here at Sarajevo. So I think the power of the financing of author's films and author-driven films is in connection and in collaboration of the region. So I always want to emphasize that it's quite important to make the rules and regulations during the financing more easier for us between in our region, because the language is one really great power. And when you watch our film, when I saw it for the first time, I was aware of that like we are watching some films from the 20th century, from Yugoslavia, while you're watching, it's not important which kind of language, the dialect, the actors are speaking, and that is the power of that. So, of course, the region is something where understanding is so important, and we are all working the same conditions. So from that perspective, of course, it's much more easier. Europe now trying through all different funds to establish the collaboration and diversity and push us to work with EU countries. But I still think that we have great power while we're working together.
Dusan, you said in one interview that you like to do small and simple stories. What do you allow the director, the author sense? By the way, your films remind me on the intimate story of British director Mike Leigh, for example, Secret and Lies and Just No Worries and Another Year.
Well, I did. Thank you. I didn't think about these films. When I said small and simple, I thought first of all in terms of production. Because when we started working on this film, it was very important, like Jelena said, to collaborate with the region, and not to go, not to spread in too much countries of co-production. Because I think, and I believe in a way, that of course it has its own advantages. I mean, you have bigger money for spending on the film, but in a way, it kills freedom and creation of the film. And for me, it was, and Jelen as well, it was very important to have this kind of freedom to experiment and to feel free to work whatever you want. You know, we've been here at CineLink and developed, and we checked our script several times with script doctors and etc. And for me, this is the useful part of the whole production. But in terms of waiting for years and years to get the money for a couple of countries, basically for me doesn't make much sense, because we are here for the film and for the filmmaking, and we are just enjoying to work with people that we want to work, either a creative team or actors. And that was important part. And while we are working on another projects as well, we always think just in terms to make easier for creative part of the crew to feel free to give their best.
In the story, the film also makes the symbol of the snake. What does the snake represent and imagination or cultural tradition in Montenegro?
Well, for this snake particularly, as I said, this is for people who are not from the region, or this is adaptation of Stribor Forest fairy tale, and I just follow the logic of this fairy tale, like the guy saves the snake that becomes woman, girl, actually, that he felt love in and feel lust and toward her, an emotion, in contrast with his mother that wants to save her son. So for me, this was not like the symbol of evil or etc. For me, it was just part of the fairy tale, but we can talk about fairy tale further if you...
You say for yourself that yours are part of our last generation. How do you define that phase, and how do you see your generation in relation to heritage of Yugoslavia?
Well, I said that we feel part of the lost generation because we grew up in a completely broken society with completely mess in a political scene and ideological sense, and we live this today more than ever, I believe, with this crazy time with pandemic and economic situation in this country, but as well with never-ending transition that we have here in all former Yugoslavia republic. And we are just waiting and waiting and waiting to be better, but nothing is better, nothing is not changing as well. So every idea of something good that is going to happen in these countries that we live in is some abstract, basically, idea. So in that sense, I believe, because when we, what will be our heritage is the enormous question. We talk about that often privately. I mean, can we all just think about important things in culture, arts, or economic that is huge in the past 30 years that happened here? You know, what is the cinematography of this whole region? How we develop? What will be our legacy is something that I often think about. So in that sense, I feel that about my generation.
Thank you. I ask the audience if there are any questions for the director, Axel, the producer, to do it now. Okay, and we finished. Thank you for your participation and attention. We continue with the films within the Sarajevo Film Festival. Thank you.